Hello everyone, in today's tutorial, I will show you how to make this outline effect without using a post-process material. So as you can see, if I click on a mesh, it gets outlined. And you can select individual colors for all the meshes. And you can also change the size of the outline. If I right click it, the outline will be gone. And if I click it again, the outline will come. So this works really well with static meshes. If you want to get the project files for this tutorial, you can support me on my Patreon. And if you like to see more tutorials like this, consider subscribing. So here I have different actors. So if I change the mesh to this one and hit play, I can now have an outline effect on that mesh. And if I select that, and I can change the color to blue maybe. You can have whatever color you want. So to create this, first we need to create the outline material. For that, right click, then material. Now I will name this m_outline. Then open it up. Then I will change the blending mode to masked and the shading model to unlit, and I will check two-sided. Now if I get a two-sided node and connect this to the MEC, we can see that the outer side will be 1 and the inner side will be 0. So if I 1 minus this and connect this to the opacity mask, now we can only see the inner side. So like that. Now we are only seeing the inner side and not the outside. So in this technique, we are only going to render the inside of the mesh. You can also do this by using Blender and inverting the normals. But here I am just going to use this method. Now we will get a vector parameter. Then I will name this color. Then I will connect this to the MEC color. Then I will give a value of 1 for red. Now we need to control the size of the mesh. So for that we will get a vertex normal. And we will get a multiply. Then connect this to B. And connect this to the world position offset. Now get a scalar parameter and I will name this scale. This will control the width of our outline. I will give a default value of 1. Then I will hit apply. Now create a material instance. And we can change the color here to green or something like that. So as you can see here, we can only see the inside of the mesh and not the outside. I will change the scale to 0.5. And now, if I get a sphere and I duplicate that and put this material on this, and if I place it above each other, you can see that we get an outline here. So with this, we can just control the width and we can also control the color. We can do this with any mesh you want. So if I get a chair mesh and if I duplicate this and if I give it this material and if I overlap it, we can get an outline with that. So now we can reduce the outline width to get the look we want. So now to do this, when we mouse over or press the actor, we can create an actor. Then I will call this BP outline. Then open it up. Then add a static mesh then go to event begin play, then go to event graph, then we will get the static mesh, then we will drag from here and type in set static mesh, and we will get the function, and we will promote this to a variable, and I will name this mesh. Then I will click this eye icon so we can change this in the editor. It will make it public. Now we need to duplicate this mesh and place it on top of the original static mesh when we call a custom event on this actor. So for that we will create a custom event. Right click and type in custom event. I will call this create outline. Then we will create a branch. Then we will promote this and I will name this as outline. And only if this is false, we will execute this part. So now from here we will type in add static mesh component. Then for the transform, we will just get the static mesh, then get world transform and connect this to the relative transform. And now I will check this manual attachment. Then here drag and type in set static mesh. And this mesh is the same one. Now we will promote this to a variable. And I will name this mesh component. Then connect this here. And connect this here. And we can connect this here. Now we will drag from here and type in create dynamic material instance. And this source material should be this outline instance. Now we can drag from here and type in set vector parameter. And the name of this one should be color, because we named this one color. Then we will promote this to a variable. And I will name this color. Then hit the eye icon. Then again we will drag from here and type in set scalar parameter value, and this time the name is scale, and we will promote this to a variable also, and I will name this scale. This will allow us to control the width of our outlines. So after doing all this, we will set this has outline variable to true. So it is true now. So this won't create any further outlines. The default value of this should be false. Now we will create the custom event to delete the outline. So for that, right click, then type in custom event, then delete outline, then we will drag in the mesh component, control drag that in, then type in is valid. We only want to delete it if it is valid, meaning that it is there. Now we will drag from here and type in destroy component. Now we will set this value to false again. So that's all we need to do here. Now we will go to the player blueprint. Now we need to show the cursor. So for that we will get player controller. Then from here type in show cursor, set show cursor, then take this. Now duplicate this get player controller, and from here we will get a mouse left button, then drag from here and type in get hit result under cursor by channel, then break the hit result and type in cast to BP outline. Then connect this here and connect this hit result actor to the object. Then we will call create outline. Then we will duplicate all of this. And here we will get right mouse button and connect this here, and we will drag from here and type in delete outline. So this will delete our outlines when we right click on the mesh. So now compile. Now we can bring in our new actor. So here you can set the static mesh you want. So I'm just going to grab one from the starter content, this one, and I will change the color to green, and I will change the scale to 2. Now hit play, and if I press the mesh, you can see that I get an outline, and if I right click it, the outline will be gone. Now this is best used on static meshes. So if you have a gun or something and you want to have a selection outline on the gun, you can use this method. And yeah, that's it. You can try different meshes. So if I get a chair, you can have the outlines like that. So if I select this capsule shape, I can have an outline for that too. You can change the colors to black or white or whatever you want. So that's it. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you like the tutorial, leave a like and subscribe. And if you want to get the project files, check out my Patreon. Thanks.